The thing about show business is that it's very difficult to get into it. But once you get into it, and if you are good, it's very difficult to get out. So I call myself an accidental journalist because I had no ambitions of being a writer. I didn't think I had any talent. And frankly, I wanted to do nothing in life. I just wanted to have a good time. So I kept fantasizing that I'm going to give it up in 1 year, I'm going to give it up in 2 years, and it's been 40 years. Started as a reporter, then as a chief reporter, then as a special correspondent, after that an assistant editor, then an editor very young in life, and also did columns, and that's how very suddenly I became an editor. I started with a movie magazine, then I launched G magazine, then I joined Screen and was there for a long time. While I was the editor of G, Amitabh Bachchan, who had not spoken to the media for almost 18 years, made up with the media. So one day my secretary said that, you know, ma'am, you can interview whom you want, but don't interview Mr. Bachchan because there are too many interviews you've done with him. And I said, no, that cannot be. So I asked her to give me prints. And when I started reading it, I felt if I rework on it a little more and do some more interviews, it had the potential of a book. And that's how I became an author. At that time, I thought that I'll just write one book and I'll be over with it. But writing is a passion. Writing is a reflex action. Writing is like breathing. If I'm not writing, I'm not thinking, I'm not living. So along with my regular job, I started doing a book a year. In 2009, I was invited by 92.7 Big FM to come and speak on the radio and do reviews for the radio. I was in the print media, I was in the radio media, I was making appearances on television, and I was writing blogs and was there peripherally on the digital media. I wanted to do a video show, but somehow it was not happening. And then one day a common friend introduced me to Archit Rastogi, and we decided that maybe we can together, holding hands, experiment with a digital video show. This was about 2.5 months ago. And all of us were on the shore, not really knowing whether we were going to swim or whether we were going to sink. Archit is a renowned editor. So we started with Sanju.
आप जरूर उनको कुछ गड़बड़ बोलते होंगे इसलिए वो स्ट्रेस में आ जाते होंगे।
I'm telling you, he is such a big prankster. He loves playing pranks. He loves making people laugh. Even on set, na, when there's like people are not smiling and laughing, he feels anxiety. Then he says, "Why aren't people smiling?" He wants people to be happy.
And the reaction and the feedback was so phenomenal that we got hooked and very intoxicated by our own channel and by our own shows.
जब भी बादल गरजते हैं, हमेशा हिंदी फिल्मों की यादें आती हैं. हिंदी फिल्मों के गाने, हिंदी फिल्मों के situations. Because nobody uses the monsoons as beautifully as our Hindi films.
We did a rain episode where I just reminisced about rain movies, rain, how it's portrayed in movies, which we did it in my building in the garden. And actually it was raining. And we even involved Archit's children in the frame. Now, we thought that with Sunny Leone's following, it is going to be a big plus, and she will probably come across as a real fataki in the interview. But we discovered that she's an ordinary girl with ordinary dreams and a very simple person.
I'm so proud of you for giving your story and for being honest.
Thank you.
And I wish you all the best.
Thank you so much.
And you're very beautiful.
Thank you so much.
And Tapsi Pannu, who spoke about her role with a lot of candor and a lot of passion, and she was absolutely sparkling.
आज इंटरनेशनल किसिंग डे है.
अच्छा ओ
तो ऐसा भी दिन होता है मुझे नहीं
पता नहीं कैसे कैसे दिन हो रखे हैं अभी आजकल तो समय में हर रोज ही कुछ अजीब अतरंगी सा दिन है
तो ऐसा दिन होना चाहिए कि नहीं
अरे यू डोंट नीड अ डे टू किस यार
यू कैन किस एनीबॉडी
या हाउ लेम इज दैट दैट्स वेरी लेम गाइस
एवरी पर्सन यू मीट यू लर्न समथिंग एवरी इंटरव्यू यू डू for the camera, you learn something about yourself and how you need to improve, how you need to perhaps make better communication, better conversations. Every writer, every journalist has a different way of doing it. Some go well prepared with questions. I just feel that if I prepare questions and I'm looking into the paper, then I'm not listening to my interviewee, and it is important to listen to them, because when you listen to them, you make eye contact, and when you listen to them, a lot more comes into your mind that you can ask them. So I was learning, I was watching, my director was guiding me, and we were trying to improve. We were getting better subscriptions, we were getting better feedback. The interview, I think that was one-on-one and shot at a cafe, was Rishi Kapoor. Rishi Kapoor is a very impatient man, and Rishi Kapoor is somebody who gets irritated very easily. So I was a very little nervous that if things go wrong and there was some hammering going on the top, he may flare up. But he was so charming, so endearing, that not just me, the entire team fell in love with him.
Dimple used to come in a huge, you know, imported car, you know, big, huge car. And I remember those days, Amitji, Mr. Bachchan used to shoot for Bombay to Goa on the adjacent floor. And we had just met, so he used to say, "Bhai, tumhari heroine to badi gaadi mein aati hai." And those days, Amitji used to come in a Fiat. And we also had a tutti frutti Fiat. So we used to rag Dimple, and Dimple used to tell us, you know, kya hai ki main picture mein kaam kar rahi hu, Raj Kapoor ki picture mein, Raj Kapoor ki star hu, Raj Kapoor ki heroine hu, picture chal gayi to star hu, agar nahi ban gayi nahi hu to main as it is badi gaadi mein to aati hi hu, main to badi star to ho hi hu as it is. So I see that way ke yeah, perhaps she was right, she was a star, we were nobodies. I mean, at least I was a nobody, Bachchan sahab was, of course. And thereon when we worked, and then now look back in retrospect, and I think, yeah, there's been a lot of hard work, a lot of blood, sweat and tears, disappointments and happiness, and whatever I'm worth today is all in the journey of these 46 years.
In between this, Dhadak was getting released, Sri Devi's daughter was getting launched with Ishan Khattar. I had seen Ishan's Majid Majidi film. He's absolutely terrific. And I was looking forward to talking to the two kids. But I was wondering, what am I going to talk to them? Nobody knows about their movie. The film was not yet released. And they were doing so many interviews that I thought everything would just be mechanical. But I think it was very warm, because I'm so much older than the kids. And when Janvi got to know that I had suggested her name, she became almost emotional. I have seen you in your mother's stomach when she was shooting for Army. Then after that, when you were born, I came to the hospital to see you. Then at the hospital, I asked mom that inki rashi kya hai, aap unka kya naam rakhne wale ho? She said, naam abhi tak mila nahi hai. To usne kaha, J hai. So I said, how about Janvi? Because it is, you know, Urmila Matondkar's name in
Judai.
So Sri rolled her eyes and she said, Janvi is nice and it will be a memory of Judai. I'll speak to my husband. How much I missed Sri Devi, because if she was there, she would have really loved it. I sent the link to her dad though, and Boni Kapoor was as emotional about his daughter. And when the film was released, he sent congratulations to me, I don't know why, and I sent congratulations to him, I know why. I am a big fan of the Indian Idol, and I love watching it. And I feel I know all the judges and all the participants. So I suggested to the team that we must do Indian Idol.
पता नहीं plus point है कि minus point है कि दो judges हमारे साथ हैं विशाल दत्तानी और नेहा कक्कर. अनु जी नहीं है
तो पता नहीं plus point है या minus point.
नहीं अनु मलिक was missed, but in a way, because अनु मलिक was not there, everybody got a chance to talk. Later, while doing the interview, I found Neha Kakkar staring at me a bit too hard. And I was tempted to ask her why she was staring. And she understood from my expression and she said, you know, I've seen you on the television and I have known about you. And I cannot believe that I'm doing the interview with you.
People want you very much, but also to get work and to get your voice and to get your fun, you have to work. There's no taking away from that.
It's like, जैसे माँबाप आपको दुनिया में ले आते हैं, फिर
जॉब तो आपने खुद ही करनी है ना, वो पढ़ा लिखा देते हैं फिर आपको आगे खुद ही लाइफ जीनी।
लेटर ऑन देयर वर मेनी इंटरेक्शंस विद नेहा एंड विद विशाल ऑन द सोशल मीडिया, नॉट जस्ट विद मी बट ऑल्सो विद माई प्रोड्यूसर काजोल। Was launched before me actually, and I've seen her grow from Bekhudi to her last film. But she's also volatile, and like Rishi Kapoor, you cannot predict her. You cannot say what is going to be her mind frame, her mood frame. But she is a live wire, and she is so vibrant and so passionate, not just about cinema, her role, but also Ajay Devgan and her kids. And her screen son, whom she said she enjoyed giving lapet to.
I slapped him so many times that nervousness went out, I think, with the first slap, and after that it never came back.
And no. When she slaps, she really slaps, or she's kind.
When there was a scene where she's supposed to slap me for the first time on set, so she's like, I'll fake it. I said, no, this is an emotional scene, intense scene, please hit me hard.
Like, it's okay, you can act. It's I said, no. Why don't you act instead?
After that, Dada loved this. The slapping thing so much that whenever he was at a loss of any idea, his idea was
the scene was not working.
Scene was not working.
There's something about it or whatever.
Thappad maar do,
it was just everybody enjoyed it so much that we made it part of the film.
Everyone is like laughing all over whenever I'm slapped. The entire set is laughing.
But is she really slapping now, or are you acting? Sometimes.
Can I show you?
No, I don't think so. It is on
at the end of it.
At the end of it.
Nobody becomes a success on his own. All success is collective. All success is a lot of hard work, a lot of focus, a lot of belief and conviction. I think in this entire journey, what is really endearing is the association with the Movie Moth. I think all of us have been very mature in this relationship that is professional and slowly turning into personal. And we are just thinking of one episode a day, one actor or a celebrity that we interview a day, one review a day. We are meeting almost twice a week. And I think our growth has been step by step and very realistic and very steady. And if all of you are going to always like, share, comment and subscribe, then we will grow by leaps and bounds. We are trying our best and we are looking forward to your cooperation, to your support. So I've done 14 books and the latest is my book on Keshava. I absolutely love it. And I am right now speaking to you from the Granth bookstore, which is so beautiful and so inspiring. I would recommend all of you to come here with your children, encourage them to read books, because if there are no readers, there will be no authors.